In today's world, cloud technologies, cross-compatibility between devices, and the ability to work from anywhere have become increasingly more relevant topics. And while many that use the Linux desktop appreciate the much more local approach without forced integrations, others miss the flexibility that Windows and macOS provide. But what if it doesn't have to be that way? In today's video, I'm going to show you some of my favorite approaches and tools to integrate my Linux desktop into my very own ecosystem, making it easier to interact with my other devices and synchronize changes wherever I am. Let's get into it! This video was made possible by channel members of our community. If you want to participate in selecting new video topics, see what's going on behind the scenes, and gain access to various tips and tricks, then please make sure to check out the join button or the link in the video description down below. Just so you know, in today's video we're going to use the desktop environment GNOME, but many of the shown tools can be used on other desktop environments as well. Okay, so by default we're not signed into anything, just our local offline user account that does not serve personalized data to a provider. But this also means that your calendar that you might have on your phone or email application is not here yet. The GNOME desktop environment, in its settings, allows us to connect to a couple of predefined cloud providers, but also many more as long as you support one of these mentioned technologies. After you are connected, you are being asked what you want to synchronize. If you are on a laptop that has a SIM card, you might be interested in importing your contacts. If you want to synchronize your events, to create, modify or delete them, get notifications on your desktop or gain access to your cloud storage straight from within the desktop environment, you can toggle each setting individually. Since the release of GNOME 46, you can also connect to Microsoft services like OneDrive or SharePoint, which allows local office suites like LibreOffice, password managers and essentially all other programs that you might want to synchronize to save and open files straight from within the file manager. In contrast to Windows, where you can cache files locally and then synchronize them later, this is not quite the same approach, but you can make it work that way if you're willing to dive down the rabbit hole of using CLI commands. What I really like about the online accounts integration is that I can choose what to synchronize. And I'm also not connecting my local account directly to the cloud service, meaning that if it bothers me, I can just simply remove it and all ties to my PC are gone. Okay, so now we covered syncing your calendar events and accessing your files. But what about your phone? On Windows, you have a pre-installed application. On macOS, you can integrate it very well out of the box by connecting your accounts. On Linux, we have KDE Connect, or on GNOME-based desktop environments, GS Connect, an extension that allows you to connect to your phone to share files, access notifications and media controls, use your phone as a remote for slides, and if you're connecting it via Bluetooth as well, you can also take phone calls straight from your Linux machine, integrating it into your daily business quite nicely. The only caveat that KDE and GS Connect have is that they have to be on the same network, which is fine in your home or university and schools that offer them, but not in scenarios where as a user only gets a one device pass. Like you can technically work around that with a personal VPN to your home network, like using Wi-Fi on your laptop and the mobile data network on your phone and then connecting to the same network, but it's very complicated for an average user. Instead, let's talk about something that an increasing number of people use. With less HDMI ports being shipped on laptops, many rely on adapters or wireless technologies to mirror their screen to a TV or projector. Sometimes they come with a physical dongle that just mimic a display to mirror to, but other times people like to use inbuilt technologies like the Windows Wireless Display functionality. The GNOME Network Displays app allows you to mirror your device to a Miracast compatible device. Now it should be mentioned that many proprietary devices like a Fire TV stick or newer models of the Chromecasts or Google TV or whatever they are called right now use their own protocol that are no longer compatible with this application. However, in a professional environment you typically don't tend to run into them. Or if it's Android based, you can cast your screen via Chromium based browsers that support the necessary protocols. One unfortunate situation of locking down environments to restrict the viewing of DRM protected content and giving the one running the platform more control. It is what it is. Let's talk about cross-compatibility of applications that are non-cloud based and if you can't substitute to anything else, including games. The Wine compatibility layer, which is also part of Proton from Valve, allows you to run many Windows programs on Linux, often close to native or even better performance. However, it's not a silver bullet, as many dependencies of Windows applications are often proprietary and have some quirks that make them incompatible, so don't expect every program to run. I personally use Bottles to set up various different environments with game launcher presets, custom Proton versions, or different dependencies that might be required for some programs. Recent Office and Adobe products don't really work, unfortunately, but for those, if you're tech savvy, you might be able to set up a virtual machine and install WinApps, which basically streams the application to your Linux machine, but still integrates everything like it was running natively. It's not an easy setup for most though, and the performance also won't be as good as running it on a more native solution. What I also found to be quite useful back on my dual booting days is sharing games between two operating systems. For example, if I was playing Valorant and then Far Cry 5, I didn't always want to boot into Linux, since maybe I would switch to Valorant again. However, when I was on Linux, sometimes I just wanted to game a bit without restarting either. In that case, you can access your games on Linux if you automatically mount the Windows NTFS disk or partition containing the games and add them to either Steam or Bottles. This way, no matter which operating system you're currently booted into, you can launch compatible games without having to install them twice. Let's also talk about some business integrations. If you have set up a server with the SMB protocol, so a file share or NAS that is compatible with Windows, Linux, macOS and Android, and you're also running a centralized identity management tool for authentication, so basically centrally managing user accounts, then one of the most common used technologies is the Kerberos protocol, and we can use that. Inside the GNOME settings, we can log in with our centrally managed user credentials and obtain a so-called Kerberos ticket, which can now be used to connect to said file shares, printers, or other managed resources without ever having to re-enter your password. For an identity-based security model, this is nice, since you don't trust the device, but rather the identity. Though you can also use a more traditional approach by adding an enterprise user that, just like on Windows, joins the device into the centralized management like Active Directory. And those were just some of the tools that I use personally or have some experience with to integrate your Linux desktop into your very own ecosystem. If you know any more tools that help you to interact with other devices in your ecosystem, or if you're using a different desktop environment that just doesn't offer some of those features, then I would be really interested on what you have to say in the comment section down below. Before I end this video, I quickly wanted to mention that if you want to support the channel and make even better videos, then please make sure to check out our membership program as well as our online shop, whereas each sale helps to support various open source projects. If you've liked this video, then please make sure to show it with a like, and also don't forget to subscribe to the channel so that you don't miss out on any future Linux videos just like this one. I really hope you had a blast watching, and as always, all that's left to say now is good morning, good afternoon, or good evening, wherever you are. I'll see you around.